Hi team, this is Chris Abraham from GoMath. Today we're working on number 63 on the Early Childhood MTEL O2 exam. This is a nice intro to corresponding angles, a key concept you're going to see on all the various types of teacher certification exams in mathematics. The gist of corresponding angles, when you have two parallel lines, y and z, crossed by a transversal, x, corresponding angles are formed. And the gist is that this angle here, the 6, corresponds to the 2 and that they're equal. All right, and that this angle 1 here corresponds to the 5 and it's equal. Well, there's a whole bunch of other rules that you could also apply here, like you could say that angles 1 and 2 are supplementary. They form a straight line. And then you could say, well, what's the supplement of 1 here? That would be 3, which means that if 1 is supplementary to 2 and 1 is supplementary to 3, that means that 2 and 3 are equal. That's our vertical angle rule, right? So this angle here would also be equal to this angle here. And it makes sense because if 1 is supplementary to 2 and 1 is supplementary to 3, then that must mean that 2 and 3 are equal. And since 3 corresponds with the 7, sort of makes sense, right? And we have all these relationships that are sort of matching up with corresponding angles, supplementary angles, and vertical angles. But there's one kind of extra sort of extrapolation from this which is easily overlooked, and that's if 1 is supplementary to 3 and 1 matches up with the 5, then you can say that 5 and 3 are supplementary. Does everyone see that? I'll just say that one more time. If 1 and 3 are supplementary, they add up to 180 degrees, and 1 is equal to the 5, then that must mean that 5 and 3 are also supplementary. All right, so chew on that for a little bit, and let's look at the question. It says, which of the following must be true for line y to be parallel to line z? And then we have these options. A, line x must be perpendicular to line y and z. B, corresponding angles formed by line x, line y, and line z must add up to 360 degrees. C, angle 3 and angle 5 must be equal. And D, angle 3 and angle 5 must add up to 180. Now, there's a lot of vocabulary here, parallel, perpendicular, corresponding. All right, I'm hoping that, you know, some of this stuff, like when you think parallel lines, you're thinking of two lines that never intersect, and perpendicular lines are two lines that intersect at 90 degrees. Now, with this, there's other things too here, though, that are kind of easily overlooked, like the language of must be true, right? Must be, must. Whenever you have must, I want you to remember that means it has to work 100% of the time. Which is, and this would be opposed to sometimes. Sometimes they have questions that say sometimes or might be. That would only mean it only has to work 1% of the time. But if it's must be, we're looking for a rule here that works all the time. And if we go through our options here, line X must be perpendicular to lines Y and Z. Well, if that were the case, right, and x was perpendicular, there's no question we would have corresponding angles that are formed, and all these relationships that we've just described would work. You know, this would match up with this, and this would match up with this, and you know, these angles would be supplementary, and these angles would be supplementary. But this is not a requirement. It's not, corresponding angles don't form just because, only for this factor. So this is one scenario where it works, but not all the time. So it doesn't have to be, so what I'm trying to get at is x doesn't have to be perpendicular for you to have corresponding angles. For that reason, we could cross it out. Now what about B? Corresponding angles formed by lines x, lines y, lines z must add up to 360. I'm not so sure what that would look like. I think what they're saying is that these angles here, you know, and these angles here, maybe they add up to 360. One, two, if we were to add up angles 1, 2, three, four. If it was just that one intersection, it would add up to 360. But not all the correspondings that all the corresponding angles that are formed with x, y, and z. That would be too much. That'd be over 360. So we could cross that one off. How about this one? Angle 3 and angle 5 must be equal. Well, if x was perpendicular to x and y, then in fact, this statement would be true. 3 and 5, angle 3 and 5 here, if this was 90 and this was 90, they would be equal. But again, we're not dealing with a scenario that has to be perpendicular. D's the right answer. Read over number D for a moment. It says angle 3 and angle 5 must add up to 180. If angle 1 is 120 and it corresponds to 5, which is 120, and angle 3 is 60, the supplement of 120, adding up to 180 degrees because it because angles 1 and 3 form a straight line, you could say if angle 1 and angle 3 add up to 180 degrees and form a straight line and are supplementary, and since angle 1 equals angle 5, then you could say that angle 5 and angle 3 also add up to 180 degrees and also are supplementary. And this is a relationship that works for all corresponding angles. So these inside angles here, when the two lines are parallel, are always going to add up to 180. All right, team, this is Chris Abraham from GoMath. I hope this video helped. Have a great day, team. Take care. Bye-bye. Hi, team. This is Chris Abraham from GoMath. This spring and fall, we're hosting a whole brand new series of workshops for teachers for math, science, English, and history. You should check out these workshops. We're going to be holding them in Massachusetts, in Florida, in New York, in California. Check them out. I'm sure you'll find them very helpful. Take care.